Is your neighbor's home for sale and you can't figure out why it's not selling? Well, this is Sean Zangane bringing you tips and tricks on how to win in the San Diego real estate market. So I get a lot of questions from clients who are thinking about selling their home and another home is on the market in their neighborhood and they can't figure out why in the hottest market of our lifetime, why the heck won't this house sell? Well, what we've seen over the last 2 years is a crazy change in the marketplace. We went from March of 2020, where everybody stopped buying a home, to June, July, where everybody got right back to the market. And 2021, we've seen one of the biggest race-ups in home values that I think any of us will ever see in our lifetime. And what's happened now is we've kind of seen a place where the market is shifting again. It's not slowing down. We're just not seeing the rapid pace of increase that we saw through February, March, April, May, June, even July of 2021. That's been absolutely insane. So what we want to do is share with you guys a few things that we're noticing in the marketplace that's actually causing homes not to sell. Number one, poor prep. Earlier this year, you literally could just put your home for sale and people would come into it and say, "I love it. Give it to me. I'll pay you $100,000 extra." Well, today, buyers, now that there's more inventory available, we're noticing buyers start to become a little bit pickier. They walk into a house and they say, "Hey, oh, this is great, but gosh, they didn't do any prep here and there's lots of stuff that's left over." One of the things our team and many other great real estate agents should specialize in is prepping a home for sale. The era of just listing it has just kind of gone away. You need to make sure that the homes are clean, that the front entrances are presentable and looking nice, that if there's some paint touch-ups, carpet replacements, simple things that add immense amount of value. People today know that with the constraint of supplies and the supply chain issues that we've seen here in the late part of 2021, a done home is gonna sell for a lot more. A home needing new appliances or things that people are waiting for today is actually negatively impacting due to all the media surrounding all the problems we're seeing with the supply chain. So today, a done home where you're doing a couple things to spruce it up to make it easier for the buyer to understand is a huge thing that is an improvement and why we're seeing homes in the late part of 2021, the homes that are truly prepped and ready for sale, selling a lot more and a lot faster than the homes where the homeowner was maybe a little lazy and the agents weren't urging the owner to really invest those dollars into the home. The next thing we're seeing is average marketing. Frankly, if you were a real estate agent in February through June this year and you had a home for sale, your job was a lot easier than it used to be. Well, all that's changing. And what we're noticing is that people are spending a lot more time studying photos, looking at media collateral before they go to a property. So make sure you're working with a real estate agent who's actually doing a full media package about your home and really creating a brand for your home to help it get top dollar. The era of just taking a couple iPhone photos and putting it on the market is not cutting it today. And then the last thing is pacing too far ahead of pricing. Over the last year, we've seen people list a home maybe 50, 100, 150 grand over what the last sale was and start to hit those numbers. What we're seeing today is people are just a lot more realistic to where the pricing is in the market, and they're studying the pricing before they even step foot in your home. The average buyer has seen all of your comparable sales, has offered on all of your comparable sales, and probably lost out on them, so they know what a house should be worth by the time they step foot in front of yours. So trying to pace too far in front of the market, what we're noticing today is the buyer community says, I'm not doing that, and punishing the sellers by not offering at all or waiting till the seller makes a price adjustment. So to prevent you from being an adjusted price in the negative or downward direction, make sure that you're pricing the home right now at the market price and not above, and let the buyer community organically take the price of the home up. So this is Sean Zangane bringing you tips and tricks on how to win in the real estate market. And if you're looking for more tips on how to sell your home for top dollar, make sure to reach out today. Thanks so much and have a great day.